Hi everyone, my name is Cesare Pagano. I am an amateur astronomer based in Italy, General Secretary of the National Association of Amateur Astronomers, and I coordinate the IAU Inclusive Outreach Subworkgroup. I'm here today to introduce our subgroup, what we do, and what are the opportunities that it offers for all. This work is the result of the effort of many people that you see listed as co-authors. First of all, why inclusive outreach? Three key points. Science, the scientific method, is a key element in our culture as human beings. It helps us being better citizens, as it shapes our mind to intellectual honesty, and it trains us to practice curiosity and logic. Astronomy has always been the most appealing science, therefore it's the best attractor for people, especially young people, to science. Moreover, it involves many scientific disciplines. People with disability must not be excluded from this chance. It would be very unfair. So, to summarize, we can say that inclusive outreach is about democracy, and this is our motivation. Let's talk about what we mean by inclusive outreach. In one sentence, it's about removing physical obstacles and adopting the right language, communicating the right way, so that everyone can participate. Let's expand a bit on to cover the basics. First of all, it is about using a proper environment. Remove physical barriers, choose the right context, and set it up appropriately. Then, it's about using multiple communication channels so that everyone can follow. For instance, information must be available both visually and verbally. Moreover, we have to explain the concepts in a way that can be understood, for instance, by using physical models that can be touched and looked at, 3D models, or better 4D models that reproduce also the time dimension, the movement. And by the way, this works for all, not just for people with disabilities, as we often deal with complex spatial concepts. Intellectual disabilities is a more articulated area, as there are many different kinds that require different approaches. There is a short introductory video that you may want to look at on the AU Inclusion website, and we give the links at the end. As a side note, you may have noticed that this presentation is with high contrast colors for people with low disability. Now, a few words about what an inclusive activity looks like. First of all, an important aspect is that inclusive activities are designed to be enjoyed by all. They are not designed exclusively for people with a specific disability. They must be designed to allow autonomous participation as much as possible, also to people with disabilities. They are not something to be scared away, though, as they can be learned step by step. It's only a matter of taking small steps out of our comfort zone, start with simple things, gain experience, and grow. At the end, they give great sense of accomplishment to both the people participating and to those organizing the activities. When you hear a person who was born blind telling you that they finally understand the meaning of sunrise and sunset, it's something you will remember. There are many individuals, associations, institutions who develop the skills, tools, and experience on inclusive outreach around the globe. Some very creative ones to design and build new tools to explain eclipses, Earth movements, constellations, and so on. If all this experience and knowledge could be put together and made readily available to all, it would be an incredible asset for the global community, just by sharing what is already there. This is where our group comes into play. Let's talk about our work group. The official name is IAU Inclusive Outreach, parentheses, Inspiring Stars, close parentheses. And it is a sub-work group of the Executive Committee Work Group Astronomy for Equity and Inclusion. It is one of about 8 subgroups started in 2020 by the Executive Committee Work Group to be operationally more effective. Our work group is focused on outreach practices that are inclusive for people with disabilities. It is a long-term program that takes the heritage of the 2019 Inspiring Stars project that ran a successful itinerant exhibit. Our very goal is to facilitate the development and broad adoption of astronomy-inclusive practices in outreach. After less than a year, the group counts 32 members, 14 of which are active contributors to the group activities that we discuss in this presentation. We have a representation from 17 countries and 5 continents to testify how much the community feels the importance of this topic and how much people become passionate about this topic once they start. Let's take a look at how we have designed to pursue our goal. As said, our main purpose is the development of inclusion practices and their adoption. This has two key elements, which are sharing and community. Sharing the knowledge and the experience is a way to grow faster together, and community is a way to make this common knowledge actually used and relevant in the field, to make it known instead of sitting on a website. These were and still are our priorities. Other than that, we want to link with and involve the major associations of people with disabilities worldwide. Institutions like the European Blind Union. It is important as they can provide the knowledge we need to do the right things in the right way. And also because they can connect our efforts with the communities of people with disabilities. Finally, we also want to develop excellence to encourage further experiments and to find new ways to expand the inclusive outreach practices. For example, in 2020, there were some experiments about online inclusive activities due to the contingent pandemic, of course. As said, our first priority was sharing and community. And this explains the choice of our first deliverable, the Inclusive Outreach Starter Kit. In fact, the experience tells that the main deterrent, the main obstacle usually is fear. Fear of a new language, new interactions, new questions that may be asked, and most importantly, fear to fail. With this kit, we try to make people feel confident in their first steps. The kit includes two key components, plus, of course, the support of our work group. First, very practical operational good practices based on 10 years' experience on the field from various outreach teams. Second, a set of 3 simple activities based on low-cost tools that can be built with some basic manual skills, all this with step-by-step instructions. Let's look at these elements in some more details. Good practices are very concrete suggestions to guide through all phases, from organizing to conducting an event or an activity. To give a feeling of what we are talking about, let me mention some of the answers we'll find in the document. How to choose and set up the room for an activity or a class with people with vision impairments. How to drive the hand of a blind person for the tactile exploration of an object. How to prepare a session with sign language interpreters. How to organize a number-serving session for people on wheelchair, telescope modifications, target selection, setup, conducting the observation. As you can see, it's very practical, useful stuff to be prepared and not to fear the first experience. But it is also useful to those with already some experience because it is a rather complete document. Coming in the near future, there is a new chapter on online activities. Here are the 3 basic activities included in the kit. They are tactile constellations, a set of stars of different sizes in scale, and a 5 meter rope that reproduces the solar system in scale. Simple models that can be built with a very low budget, in the order of tens of dollars, simple manual skills, but still there is quite a bit of science that can be explained with them. They have been used successfully on the field for several years now. The kit is available from the Inclusion Work Group website. The link is at the end of the presentation. On the same website, there are many more tools with different complexity and cost level that you can browse through. After a few months of our group existence, the list of things we would like to do has grown much faster than the list of things we were able to complete, which is a good thing. This slide lists several of them. Let me mention some we are trying to get started in the short term. Grow the community and gather more resources. We know there is much more around in terms of assets and experience, and we would like to connect with them and share with all. Evolve the repository of tools and resources to be more effective. As the database grows, we would like to introduce more advanced categorization and search capabilities to make it more usable. Arrange a yearly symposium, a way to get together regularly, share what we learned, and design the next steps. Arrange specific education. Good practices are a good start, but having real classes developed possibly with the support of associations of people with disabilities would be more effective. Define metrics to measure our activities and their impact on society, to be aware of where we are doing good and where we need to improve. Add much more. Anyone who wants to contribute is always welcome. What can you do to help? At least one of these three things. Even if you don't have time to invest in your experience with inclusive outreach, you can at least tell others. It will be great help for us. Then, if you want to start practicing inclusion in your outreach activities, you just found a community that can help you. Please do give it a try and let us know how it worked. We are always interested to hear your feedback. And by the way, help us spread the word. Finally, if you have experience with inclusion practice and or if you want to contribute to our activities that we mentioned, you are welcome to join the Cyber Work Group. And please, in any case, help us spread the word. Here is how to stay in touch. You can follow the IAU Astronomy for Equity and Inclusion Facebook page, where we will post regular updates about our activities, availability of resources, call for help, and so on. We are also working to set up a Facebook group so that it will be easier for the community to share information. We have a dedicated page on the IAU Astronomy for Inclusion and Equity website, and there you can find the introductory video, the starter kit. On the website, you can find many more useful resources and information. For any kind of information or inquiry, there is a dedicated email address, which is iau-inclusiveoutreach@uai.it. And yes, the domain is uai.it. It's not a mistake. This closes our session. I hope you found this information valuable, and please do help us spread the word. If there is any question, please do ask now or at a later time via email. Thank you very much.